This is Robotron 2084. It came out by Vid Kidz in March of 1982. It was released by Williams. The designers Eugene Jarvis and Larry DeMar had worked for Williams, and they designed their own company, and they released this particular game. And since they had strong ties with Williams, Williams ended up distributing it in the arcades. They did release kind of a sequel after this called Blaster. And before this, Eugene Jarvis had written Defender and Stargate. If you listen to some of the sounds, you'll realize that they came from the video game Defender. This is kind of a cool game because it uses two joysticks, an 8-way joystick to move and an 8-way joystick to fire. So you can move left and fire in any direction, or you can move down and fire in any direction. That came about because Eugene Jarvis, well, at the time, he had a cast on his hand because he got in an auto accident and he couldn't hit the fire button like in the game Berserk, and so he was thinking about what to do, and so he had a prototype with a couple of Atari 2600 joysticks, and he had a 2 8-way joysticks, and that's really cool. Now later on, Smash TV and other games use that same kind of thing, and it works really, really, really well. The name Robotron 2084 was originally called 2084 Robotron. But when the game was being designed, everybody just called it Robotron. So at the last minute, they swapped it and called it Robotron 2084. So they switched the name backwards. They were sued by Disney because Disney had the movie Tron that had come out, and Robotron, Tron, but Williams actually won that lawsuit. The reason it's 2084 is because George Orwell had a book called 1984, and in 1984, these things weren't going to happen, so they pushed it forward 100 years. So instead of 1984, it's 2084. The basic premise is that you have a guy, and you go around with a multi-directional anti-robot laser, and you shoot all of the robots. Now, the world has been taken over by these evil robots, kind of like Battlestar Galactica or Terminator. That theme was very, very popular at that particular time. And you go around, you're shooting on them, and you're trying to save the human families, the last human families. There's the mommies, there's the daddies, and then the Mikeys, the kids. No, Mikeys is like the life cereal. Hey, Mikey, he likes it. That's where the Mikeys come from. And so you go around, you run over the humans, and you shoot all of the bad guys. Now, this game was a really, really cool game for its time. It's like an in-your-face, kind of super-fast, everything is on you at once. And let me tell you, this is one of the toughest games ever to play. When you played Stargate and Defender, the controls are just horrible, but it works, and they were very popular. So those games, even though kids would have a tough time to play them, that's because of the controls. This game is like super, super, super fast and super tough to play. And I only get through a few levels and I get killed. But you know what? It's a blast. Very, very cool game. A blast from the past.